Gordon was feeling bunged up. "It's the coal, Gordon," explained his fireman. "It's clogged up your tubes something awful, but we'll have to make do with it, for there's nothing else." "Why not have a good sneeze, Gordon?" suggested Henry, thinking of the time he'd punished some boys for dropping stones on him. "That'll clear your tubes."
"Certainly not," replied Gordon with dignity. "Sir Topham Hatt wouldn't approve. He didn't like your sneeze, I seem to remember."
The next day, Gordon was nervous as he backed down onto the express.
"At least I shan't slip today," he thought, "but I suppose they'll all laugh at me again if I don't keep time."
He needn't have worried. By the time they reached the junction, he was running nicely. And as he approached Edwards Station, Gordon's fireman began to make up the fire. "Let's get a good run at the hill while you've got steam to do it," he said. "I don't trust this low-grade coal." At the station, a party of wedding guests in all their best clothes were standing on the platform. As Gordon swooshed through, running hard for the hill, smoke from the newly made fire streamed from his funnel. He had disappeared into the distance and left a black smoke screen settling over the station. It covered everything, wedding guests and all, in a coat of soot and smut. The waves to Gordon became shaking fists, and the wedding party hurried angrily to the station master's office. At the end of the line, the inspector came to see Gordon. His message from Sir Topham Hatt was short but not sweet.
"It's not fair," complained Gordon to Boko. "How could I help the smoke? It's not my fault the coal's dirty."
"Never mind," said Boko encouragingly. "Where would I be if I got upset every time someone called me smelly? Anyhow, soot's good for the garden, my driver says."
"But not good for new clothes," muttered Gordon.
Gordon was extra careful on the way home, but it wasn't his lucky day. Sir Topham Hatt had broken the journey to the other railway to apologize to the passengers at Edwards Station. He had done his best and was waiting for another train when Gordon came by. As the express thundered through, a cloud of something flew from it and landed on Sir Topham Hatt's new top hat. When Gordon reached the big station, there was another message waiting for him. "Sir Topham Hatt says," announced the inspector, "that Gordon blew ashes on his top hat as he passed through Edwards Station." Gordon was horrified. "Whoosh!" he exclaimed indignantly.
"I did not! I was being extra careful!"
"I'm sure Sir Topham Hatt can't be right," put in Gordon's fireman. "I can't help it," said the inspector. "That's just what he says. So that's that. He'll speak to Gordon when he gets home." Gordon was sent sadly back to the shed.